Hi, I'm Julien Stenner. I'm gonna present a paper written jointly with Maurice Herli, Sergio Rajboom, and Michel Reynal, my advisor. It's called Computing in the Present of Concurrent Solo Executions. I'm first gonna present the base model from which we defined our DSolo models, namely the RAID-free shared memory and message passing models. I'm then gonna explain how we define the what we call the DSolo models between shared memory and message passing weight tree models, starting from the iterated immediate snapshots that are memory primitive equivalent to shared memory. Then I'm gonna present the D-epsilon approximate agreement model, that is a generalization of the well-known approximate agreement that is solvable in shared memory weight in a weight free manner. Finally, I'm gonna show that the DSolo models hierarchy spans from shared memory to message passing models, and thanks to the D epsilon approximate agreement problem, we're gonna show that this hierarchy is strict in terms of computability. So first, I'm talking about weight-free models, but what is a weight-free model? It has actually two meanings. It is first a progression condition, meaning that each operation by any process should terminate in a finite number of steps, whatever the level of concurrency. But it's also a resiliency property, stating that even if n minus 1 of the n processes are crashing, the system is still gonna work. So all the models considered in that paper, in that talk, are all weight-free in both meanings. Now that we stated the progression condition and the resiliency property for our system, we have to define a way to communicate for our processes. So it could be, for example, a shared memory. In this talk, I'm gonna refer to shared memory to designate a single writer multi-reader atomic registers, non-bounded actually. Differently, we can also consider a message passing system in which the processes are communicating, sending asynchronous messages whose delivery time is finite but unbounded. Something I'd like you to remark now is that in a message passing model following the weight-free progression condition and resiliency property, all the processes may have to decide as if they were alone, because they can't wait for the other processes, because we have to progress even if they are all crashed. And since the delivery time of the messages is unbounded, we cannot wait for all the messages to arrive neither. So we may have to decide as if we were all alone. So in a message passing weight-free model, up to n processes can feel alone. It's not the case in a shared memory system, because to be quick, I'm gonna do that with two processes. If you consider P1 and P2 that are both writing then reading, whatever the interleaving of the events, one is gonna see the other's value. So by writing and reading, I mean that they are going to read the other one's register. So not both of them can feel solo during the whole execution, because as soon as they write and read both of them, one is gonna see the other. It entails that at most one process in a shared memory weight-free system can feel alone. So the question now is, what can be computed in a system in which we have a number of processes that can feel alone, that is comprised between n and 1, so let's say d. So to try to define such a system, we started from the shared memory model that we know is equivalent to the iterated immediate snapshot model. In that model, processes communicate through an object that is associated to the round. They execute the round asynchronously, and communicating through the object is done in an atomic manner through an operation called write snapshot. During that operation, the process instantaneously writes and takes a snapshot of the whole memory. Here, atomic has a special meaning. It's not linearizability as we are used to use it, but it's set linearizability, which means that processes can execute the write snapshot at the same time, in which case they see each other and have exactly the same view of the memory. in their snapshot. So let's look at what can happen during one round in a system of four processes doing all their write snapshots concurrently or not. We can first have the processes coming one by one in the memory. I'm gonna represent that with the rules that are transitive and mean that a process see another one in its snapshot. So for example here, the first process to come is process one. It comes and write and snapshot the memory and see only itself in the memory and terminates for this round. Then the process two is coming and see writes in the memory and see both of the values of processes one and two, and so on for processes three and four. Now we can also have the dual situation when all the processes arrive concurrently, write concurrently the memory, and all see each other in their snapshot. And obviously all the hybrid situations. Now we can see that even if a round like this one repeats forever, only one process is gonna feel alone during the whole execution. And the same is in that situation or in one of these two situations. But in any other situation, several processes see each other and they know that they are not alone to run. Now to define our DSolo models, we are gonna add a property to the iterated immediate snapshots model in order to allow more behaviors for the communication object of the round. So for example, we can say that the first set of processes to access the memory can miss each other, but they can't be more than D processes. So for example, if we add the new behaviors for four processes with D equals to two, we add these possibilities, so two solo processes, then all the usual possibilities. I'd like you to remark that these are pretty close to these two, this one and this one, but this arrow that meant that the two first processes were seeing each other does not exist anymore. So if that kind of round repeats forever with the same two processes in front, then they are gonna feel alone, the both of them, during the whole execution. And if we take D equals to 3, then we add an additional behavior with three processes alone that miss each other, and that is defining our communication object and its behavior during one round. And when we repeat that across an entire execution, it's defining what we call the DSolo model. Now let's have a look at the extreme cases. What's the one solo model? It has been completely done to match that, so it's exactly the shared memory model. If you look at the additional properties we added to the immediate snapshots communication objects, does not change anything for D equal 1, because you can always have one process alone, even with a memory. At the other extreme, the N solo model allows all the behaviors, including the all the processes, not exchanging any message during any round. So it matches the wait-free message passing model. Now we know that these two models are different in terms of computability. You can compute more things in the shared memory model, strictly more things than in the message passing model. So the question now is, are the new models, the new DSolo models, equivalent to one of the extreme models, shared memory or message passing? Or are they forming a hierarchy spanning from message passing to shared memory? For that, we are going to consider a problem that we defined to match exactly the computation power of a DSolo model. So the D-epsilon approximate agreement is defined as follows. So it's a one-shot task. Processes propose a value of a large dimension space. They decide a value in a finite number of steps. All the decided values are proposed values. And the agreement property, up to D processes can decide any valid value. And all the other processes have to decide a value that is at a distance smaller than epsilon from the polytop formed by the values decided by the first processes. So this defines our D epsilon approximate agreement, And one can remark that it's an extension of the approximate agreement that is a fundamental problem in the weight free shared memory model. As expected in the DSLO model, we can solve the D epsilon approximate agreement differently in the D plus 1 solo model, so one that allows a few more behaviors for the communication object. We can't solve it anymore. This means that we have a hierarchy that spans from message passing, so the N solo model, to the shared memory, so the 1 solo model. And the existence of the D epsilon approximate agreement shows that you have non-trivial tasks that you can solve in the D solo model, but not anymore in the D plus 1 solo model. In terms of computability, this hierarchy of model is strict. There is additional work that has been done in the full paper. We did a topological study of the complex of the executions in the DSLO model. So it means studying the structure of the complex itself and the relationships between two executions. For example, if a set of processes cannot distinguish between two executions, then it's gonna appear in the description by the topology. We also provided a characterization of the colorless tasks that can be computed in a DSLO model. And as I presented during this talk, we defined a new hierarchy of models that spans from weight-free message passing to weight-free shared memory, and that is strict. The full paper has been accepted at Latin 14 and is gonna be published in the following months. Thank you for your attention.